εκείνο το μάθες μισό. Μα συλλαβίζεις τα όνειρά σου στο Άργος και, στο Άργος και στον Ηλισσό. Μα συλλαβίζεις τα όνειρά σου στο Άργος και, στο Άργος και στον Ηλισσό.
Ξαναδώ στους μαξέδες, τρεις του Σεπτέμβρη να περνάς.
Explain to us what you know and how you found out about the revolt.
About the revolt? I'll tell you right now. In the crematorios, was working with us a Greek guy, a very short Greek guy, which he was an officer in the Greek army, cavalry. Joseph was his name. I don't know the second name, I don't remember. Maybe Dario Ger, told you. That was a military type. And the way it was, the crematorios, 1, 2, 3, and 4, was in each one of them was separated, except the Canada Commando, it was streets, which they were coming from Auschwitz, from at the end of the Birkenau, from this side of Birkenau, they were coming to the west, to us, walking in those streets. I can make you a design if you want to. So, crematory 1, 2, 3, and 4. Every night, at 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock, whatever it was, they were coming, about two of them, new guards, to go and get the post. It was a big post, like that. And they were coming full of arms. I mean, they had guns, and they had the
rifles?
Rifles and the
machine guns.
Machine guns, to go and get the post. Was two or three, I don't remember exactly, in each way they were coming every night. They were changing guards. So this Baru, Joseph, I mean, not Baru. Baru was his father-in-law, which we killed him, they killed him over there, and like I told you, with my cousin, that he was his father-in-law. So they said, with friends, talking about that, we're going to get killed anyway. He said, what about if we make something, maybe somebody's going to be liberated. And he gave us all his points, how and when. In the meantime, we heard about it, that partisans, Polans, they were in contact with us, with somebody else in the camp, I don't remember exactly, but actually with a couple of us, a Poland couple, they were in contact with us. So, how was the schedule I made? Because it was ahead. He had brains. So, in the crematorial ones, going like this, 2, 3, and 4, coming this, we got two guards in each crematorial, which we are 200 people, 300 people working, 200, at least 200 people working in each crematorium at the time. We can kill them, those two guards. Then, when they pass by, get his rifles, his arms, and going out, when they pass by, just jump on them. There are two or three of them. We are so many. Get their clothes and get the machine guns and so on. In the same time, in the 4 crematoriums. So we are 2, 3, 8 Germans. We can have 8 machine guns. And so that was a good idea of him. And all the Greeks agree. Then from them, he said, we're going right into the Birkenau, on the barracks. We're going to make a mess over there. And from there, who knows, God knows, we're going to Auschwitz. We're going to get killed. We know that. But over here, we're working for them. We're going to get killed anyway. So the Greek people all agree. The Poland people, they were so strong and so big, they were afraid somehow. They were not just to believe in it like the Greek people. The Greek people were more courageous. In the meantime, this Joseph was talking all the time with the capo we had, with a short guy of capo. And the capo was agree with him because it was 2-3 years working over there at the capo.
We're going to stop now and change the tape. Mm-hmm. Mr. Venezia, you were talking about how the uprising was planned and how this Polish capo was working with Joseph. Mm-hmm. Tell us more about what happened and what you found out.
Well, we were talking all the time with Joseph. And Joseph told us that be prepared because who knows, today, tomorrow, or next week, we're going to have the signal from the partisans and to make the revolution. What you have to do, he said, is to get some knives, because we couldn't find knives over there from the transport that were coming, and get some heavy clothes and some boots, if it's possible, which we could have it over there. And when the time is coming and we're going to say, we make the do. Do means that time just started.
You mean the signal to start?
The signal, do. Then we're going to do the same way, like I said, the first thing, kill the two guards inside, go outside, the guards are going to change over there outside, get the clothes, German clothes, and get the shotgun and the
machine gun.
And from there we're going into the Birkenau and so on. Okay.
What, can I ask you, what was the signal supposed to be?
Do.
But what was it? What were you supposed to see? How were you supposed to know that the revolt was beginning?
Oh, because every night we were preparing already. We had our clothes in on us because we were in our blocks inside the barracks. And we had the knives. So we were waiting the order from Joseph to say, now is the time. Especially the time when they were passing by. And was expecting that order. So waiting and waiting and waiting many times we were ready to do that, the order was not coming. So take away the knives, hide them again, and so on. And so on was